Good afternoon, everyone. I'll be talking on status of aquaporin-4 antibody in optic neuritis in a tertiary eye center and its implications. As we know, optic neuritis is inflammation of the optic nerve, which can be idiopathic or it can be due to demyelinating lesions like multiple sclerosis and neuromyelitis optica. It's important to differentiate between the two, and to help us in this is a aquaporin-4 antibody, which is a highly specific and a sensitive serum marker also for neuromyelitis optica. So why is this serum aquaporin-4 antibody so important? Because both neuromyelitis optica and multiple sclerosis can present with optic neuritis and similar neurological features, especially in the opticospinal variety of multiple sclerosis. It's also important to differentiate between the two because they both have got different treatment modalities, and a particular treatment modality can be detrimental in the other. So what does the literature say? Just two papers from India and two from that also from South India. In the first paper, the lacuna is that deals with this antibody only in severe cases of optic neuritis. And there's another article in a neurological journal, Serological Markers Associated with MO and MO Disorders in South India. And the lacuna is that it doesn't explain the role of serological marker as a predictor for visual prognosis in MO, being primarily from a neurology point of view. So we decided to investigate the presence of aquaporin-4 antibody and determine its prognostic value for visual and neurological outcome in patients with optic neuritis presenting to a tertiary eye center in eastern India. So this was a single center prospective study done over a 3-year period. Optic neuritis was defined. Serum aquaporin-4 antibody positive patients were included as NMO spectrum disorder. Patients who presented with optic neuritis as first feature were included. Those who had neurological abnormality at presentation were excluded along with other optic neuropathies. Typical and atypical optic neuritis was defined. Those who had mild disc edema without much hemorrhage or exudative spontaneous resolution were considered to be typical optic neuritis. So aquaporin-4 antibody was detected by indirect immunofluorescence assay, androcement examination, fundus examination, fields, VP was done. Neurological evaluation was done. MRI brain was done in all our patients. MRI orbit and spine was done in suspected opticospinal MS and NMOSD patients. Complete hemogram and autoimmune workup was done. CSF analysis was done in few of the severe optic neuritis patients. Acute phase treatment of intravenous methylprednisolone, 1 gram per day for 3 to 5 days with a short course of oral steroid was given for 11 days. If the patient was seropositive, they referred to the neurologist for further management. We had a total of 106 patients, females outnumbering males with a median age of 34 years. So we found seropositivity in 5 of our cases, out of which 3 developed transverse myelitis in the next couple of months. All of these were included as NMO spectrum disorder. 2 were seronegative, but other features suggested them to be suffering from NMOSD. We had 10 patients on follow-up who developed MS. 71 patients were monophasic, 8 patients developed chronic relapsing inflammatory optic neuropathy, and 10 developed recurrent isolated optic neuropathy. All of these 5 seropositive patients plus the 2 seronegative NMOSD patients had atypical optic neuritis. In all our patients, we had 22 atypical and 84 with typical optic neuritis. So serum aquaporin-4 antibody was positive in 22.7% of our patients with atypical optic neuritis and none in patients with typical optic neuritis. More patients who had bilateral optic neuritis or who had recurrent optic neuritis or who went on to have transverse myelitis were seropositive as compared to seronegative, and this was significant. This is a representative case of NMO with atypical disc edema, seropositive, and after recurrent attack, we can see that the disc became pale. These are MRI findings of the orbit of optic nerve and of the spine, corroborating the finding of NMO. Although the mean initial presenting visual acuity in both the seropositive and the seronegative cases were comparable, however, at the end of the follow-up, more patients who were seronegative had a better visual acuity than the seropositive cases, and this was significant. More patients who were seronegative had a complete recovery than the seropositive cases. This is a Kaplan-Meier analysis which summed up the visual outcome. More patients who were seronegative had a visual acuity of at least 636 at the end of the study period as compared to seropositive, and this was significant by log rank test. To sum up, overall aquaporin-4 antibody was positive in 4.7% of all the patients. Atypical optic neuritis was seen in 20.7% of all the patients. Serum aquaporin-4 antibody was positive in 22.7% of patients with atypical optic neuritis and none with typical optic neuritis. Seropositivity helps in distinguishing between MS and NMO. 3 seropositive patients developed transverse myelitis. Seropositive cases have more recurrences, are more bilateral, and have got poorer visual outcomes. a Japanese study, in their study on optic neuritis, had 12% seropositivity as compared to 4.7% in our cases. A Australian study put the seropositivity rate as 2.6%, so we are somewhere in between the Japanese and the Western data. In a study by Ambika et al., aquaporin AB was positive in 20% of its patients with severe optic neuritis, something similar to our study. In a study by Pandit et al., they had 5% patients who developed NMO, and in our study, 4.7% developed NMO, but they had not done this seropositivity test. 60% seropositive cases developed transverse myelitis in a series, which was similar to the Japanese study. Overall, anti-aquaporin for IgG positive patients were mostly female. This was seen in other studies too. To sum up, to conclude, serum aquaporin for antibody may be considered an important investigation in cases with atypical optic neuritis to help in timely diagnosis of underlying condition, decision making for treatment, and long